We've been taught that our identity comes from the land, and our songs are on the land, and that when you do an environmental assessment does not come up. People don't ask those questions of how are you going to be impacted. They just tell you that there's going to be lots of jobs and lots of money coming into the area, and so we need to let this mine go through.
No matter whether they're in Canada or in Guatemala or in the Philippines, they share that common sense of commitment to the land. And it forms who they are. And so when that land is harmed, then they feel it in their bodies and in their minds and in their souls. It's a deep violation.
Mine and environmental degradation mean that Inuit and Baker Lake have lost access to traditional hunting grounds, and important animals have changed their migration routes. In those ways, the mine is contributing to the loss of traditional knowledge and cultural practices.
La minería con su explotación ignora que somos parte de un cuerpo.
Our extended family extends and includes the natural world. Our totems, therefore, we also speak for the animals, the birds, the fish, and other life forms.
When we went back in June of 2011, it was a construction zone. That creek that we did hunt in was gone, and there was a dam being built. And you know, to this day, I can't think of how that dislocation for my daughter is going to impact her. What she's going to see, what she's going to have are waste rocks and an open pit and a tailings pond.